Now let's write a program to find maximum element in an array. You are given with list of numbers and you have to find which number is the biggest. So if you take the list of these six numbers, almost instantly we can recognize that 9 is the biggest number, right? That's because human brains work amazingly fast. Now let's slow down and check what we are actually doing. Let's consider a list of these numbers. Now we have to find the biggest number here. Take it slow. We scan each and every number and we try to find a bigger number. In this column, we are able to find 63 as the bigger number. After that, we will start comparing each number to 63 and check if we are able to find any more bigger number, right? 61, 22, 12, 92. So 92 is even more bigger. Now we will remember 92 and forget about 63. Now we will compare all the numbers with 92 and check if we can find a bigger number. Here we have 96. Then we will compare numbers to 96 and then check if we are able to find even more bigger number. No. Then we conclude 96 is the biggest number. You need a variable called max to store the maximum value. And then you need an iterator to scan the array. Let's say this is an array called A. So this is A of 0, A of 1, and this is A of 5. The size of the array is 6. Let's first assume that maximum value is the first element itself. And then we can change later on if we are able to find a bigger number than the first number. So now we need a loop. The loop should start from I equal to 1 because we have already assumed that A of 0 is the maximum. Now I is less than 6 because 6 is the size of the array, but in arrays we refer to the last element with A of size minus 1 because we start with 0. So that is why I have given less than 6 here. You can even say less than or equal to 5. And each time you have to increment I by 1. So now we have to compare max with each of the element, right? Each of the element is nothing but A of I. If that element is greater than max, then max has to be changed because our assumption is wrong. We have got a number greater than max. So change max to that number. That's it. This is the logic. We do have to work on how to get the input from the user. So now we are just going to declare an array here. And now is the number 6 okay here? Then you should ask the user to enter only 6 numbers. It sounds odd, right? Maybe we should declare a bigger array. Say like 100. Again, this is a bad practice. Say if the user wants to enter only 6 numbers. The remaining space allocated for 94 integers is just waste. That memory in your computer has been allocated for this program, but it remain unused, which is not a good thing. That is why we have dynamic memory allocation, linked list, so that you can just allocate the space that you want. Not more, not less. I just want to keep things simple in this video, so I'm not going to discuss about this, but just want to let you know that what we are doing here is not a good practice. Okay, now how to get the input from the user? If you just have to get one value, you can say scanf %d ampersand of that value. But here you are going to get a series of values. So you need to add the scanf within a loop. I equal to 0 because array starts with 0. Less than, you need to know what is the length of the array beforehand. Only then you can scan those many number of elements. So you should first ask the user how many numbers they are going to enter. And then you should scan that value and store it in a variable called maybe size. Let's declare that as well. So now you know the size of the array. So you have to run the loop until the size of the array and store it in A of I. So that's it. Here, instead of hard coding this as 6, you just have to change it to size. And then after the loop, you can have a printf statement to print what is the maximum value that we have found. So that's it. Let's execute this program. Let's enter 4 numbers. 45, 67, 32, 43. Max value is 67.